Competitive exams can be very difficult to crack. We are here to help you for competitive exams like VVM. So welcome to Science Pedagogics and learn more with us. But do like, share and subscribe before you start the video. And also keep updated about all the new videos we introduce.
Namaskar students, welcome to Science Pedagogics. Children, today we are going to start a series of question bank, basically to help students which are going to appear in Vidyarthi Vigyan Manthan exam. So let us start with the first, that is Indian contribution to science. Today we are going to discuss question answers of chapter number 4, that is historical evolution of medicinal tradition in ancient India. Question first, that is which Sanhita is related with general medicine? And the answer is Charak Sanhita. Charak Sanhita is related with general medicine. Next is that which Sanhita is related with surgery? That Sushruta Sanhita is related with surgery. Question 3, which Sanhita is related with pediatrics? Pediatrics means that is related with the treatment of infant, child or very small children. The answer is Kashyapa Sanhita. Now next question, name the branches of Ayurveda. First, general medicine, surgery, ophthalmology, that is related with eyes, ENT, that is related with ear, nose and throat, dentistry, pediatrics, that is related with children, psychiatry, mental disorders or any mental problem, toxicology, that is related with poison, rejuvenate medicine means how can we remain young forever, and reproductive medicines. So these are all 10 branches of Ayurveda which we have studied in ancient time, means these branches are practiced in ancient time. Now next is, who compiled 8 branches of Ayurveda into one compend? Means name the scientist who compiled all 8 branches of Ayurveda, jisne Ayurveda ki 8 branches ko compile karke sirf ek hi book mein usne compile kiya tha, and the answer is Vagbhata. Next is, what is the name of book, means compendium, which includes specialized knowledge of 8 branches of Ayurveda. Yani Vagbhata ne jo book likhi thi usme Ayurveda ki 8 branches ki complete detailed specialized knowledge thi. To us book ka naam kya tha? That Ashtanga Samgraha. Ashtanga Samgraha. Or we can just modify this question. Ab ye question aise bhi aa sakta hai. Who wrote Ashtanga Samgraha? Then answer is Vagbhat. Name the shorter version of Ashtanga Samgraha. Ashtanga Samgraha ka ek shorter version ye. Jaise hamare yahan Bhagavad Gita ka ek shorter version hai, isi tarike se Ashtanga Samgraha ka jo shorter version hai, uska naam hai Ashtanga Hriday. So Ashtanga Hriday is the shorter version of Ashtanga Samgraha. Next is, name the place where evidences are found to show that surgery practices were there in Harappan civilization. Children, आपको ये जानके बहुत ज़्यादा आश्चर्य होगा कि हमारे हरप्पन सिविलाइजेशन के टाइम से ही आयुर्वेदा में सर्जरी की प्रैक्टिस की जाती थी. So, name the place means fossils, जब हमने dig out किए साइंटिस्ट ने, तो वो उस प्लेस का आपको नाम बताना है जहां पर कि इसके एविडेंसेस मिले हैं कि हरप्पन संस्कृति में, हरप्पन सिविलाइजेशन में सर्जरी प्रैक्टिस होती थी. एंड द नेम ऑफ दैट प्लेस इज मेहरगढ़ इन पाकिस्तान. मेहरगढ़ इन पाकिस्तान. नाउ नेक्स्ट इज, इन विच एज हरप्पन एंड लोथल सिविलाइजेशन इज कंसीडर्ड. मीन्स हरप्पा और लोथल की जो सिविलाइजेशन है वो कौन सी एज में कंसिडर की जाती है? वी हैव स्टोन एज, ब्रॉन्ज एज, कॉपर एज. सो द राइट आंसर इज ब्रॉन्ज एज. हरप्पन सिविलाइजेशन जो है वो ब्रॉन्ज एज में कंसिडर होती है. ओके okay? Now next is that surgical practices were supposed to be started during which civilization? Surgical practices, जो operation वगैरह होते थे, वो practices कौन सी civilization में start हुई थी? That is Harappan and Lothal civilization. Okay. Next question is, what is the another name of surgery in prehistoric society? Prehistoric society के अंदर surgery का दूसरा नाम क्या था? And the answer is trepanation. Trepanation. Who is the father of surgery? That is Sushruta Sanhita. Sushruta Sanhita is the father of surgery. Now next question is, name the common Ayurveda surgical practices in ancient time. पुराने समय में, ancient time में Ayurveda की जो surgical practices होती थी, उनकी important branches क्या थी या उनकी कौन-कौन से नाम थे? First is rhinoplasty. Second one is reconstruction of nose. Third is surgical removal of cataract. Then surgical management of urinary calculi means that is reproduction related PGPB diseases and health diseases and reproductive health से related उनका treatment भी आयुर्वेदा में उस समय किया जाता था. Specific species of ants as dissolvable sutures to close the intestine means intestine में अगर कोई भी suture है यानी कोई भी hole present है कोई rupture हो गई कहीं से तो उसका treatment एक special species की ant से किया जाता था. Next step, which branch of Ayurveda explains genetic basis of disease? Disease जो है वो genetically भी transfer होते हैं, यानी कुछ diseases ऐसी हैं जो parents से offspring से यानी बच्चों में आती हैं, उन diseases को हम genetics diseases कहते हैं. तो Ayurveda की कौन सी branch जो है वो genetic basis of diseases को explain करती है? And the right answer is Charak Sanhita. Next is, according to Charak Sanhita, what is the name of reproductive element? Charak Sanhita ke according jo hai, wo element ki, yani life ki reproductive unit kya hai? That is bija. How many parts are there of reproductive element? Bija. Yani bija ke kitne reproductive parts hote hain? That is bij, bhaga and bij, bhagya, vyavya. Okay? Bij, bhaga and bij, bhagya, vyavya. Next is, inoculation of smallpox. Smallpox vaccine was discovered by which scientist? That is Edward Jenner. Next is, which British physician studied the Indian method of inoculation of smallpox? Smallpox ke jo inoculation ka Indian method tha, usko kis British scientist ne, British physician ne study kiya tha? And the answer is J.Z. Holwell. J.Z. Holwell. Next is, according to the Sushruta Sanhita, lower life forms are classified. Now children, the lower life means microorganisms. Now we are using a different term for these lower life, that is microorganisms. And in Ayurveda, lower life are classified into basically two parts, pathogenic part and non-pathogenic. Pathogenic means which are the main cause of diseases, and these are non-disease causing microorganisms. Pathogenic means which cause disease, non-pathogenic which do not cause disease. Next is, communicable diseases and epidemics are described in which branch of Ayurveda? Ayurveda ki kis branch mein communicable diseases and epidemics? Epidemics jo bahut ek large area ko cover karti, that is called as epidemics. For example, now the COVID-19 virus, it covers the all over world. So now it is called as pandemic. Okay? Epidemic and pandemic. Epidemic for a particular area and pandemic means throughout the world. So Ayurveda ki kaun si branch communicable diseases or epidemics ko describe karti hai? And the answer is Sushruta Sanhita. Question number 21, that according to Sushruta Sanhita, which one is the best method to control epidemics? Epidemics ko control karne ka best method kaun sa hai? That is fumigation. And children, you must be aware about this thing, that to control COVID-19, we also have done, or government of India have done so many times fumigation to control that pandemic. So it means jo hum treatment ki policies aaj use kar rahe hain, wo ancient time mein Ayurveda mein hamare scientist उस समय यूज किया करती थी. सो नाउ वी कैन अंडरस्टैंड दैट हाउ मच डेवलप्ड आर आयुर्वेदा एट दैट टाइम आल्सो. द नेक्स्ट फैक्ट इज, इंडियन राइनोप्लास्टी वाज डिस्कवर्ड बाय टू ब्रिटिश साइंटिस्ट. मींस इंडियन की जो राइनोप्लास्टी है वो दो ब्रिटिश साइंटिस्ट ने डिस्कवर की थी. उनका नाम क्या है? फर्स्ट इज थॉमस क्रूसो एंड नेक्स्ट इज जेम्स फिंडले इन अक्टूबर 1794. So this is all about today. Children, I hope these questions would be helpful in your Vidyarthi Vigyan Manthan Parishad. In our next video, we will discuss some more questions, some more chapters. Till then, bye, have a nice day, and all the best to all of you.
Thank you for watching. Do like, share and subscribe if you found the video knowledgeable. Also, let us know अगर आपको ऐसे ही और किसी competitive exams के बारे में training चाहिए, we'll do it.